welcome to the finals hall here in Munich, Germany, for the last final of our stay here, 60-meter rifle, three positions men. I'm Hillary Russell, and have the pleasure of having Germany's rifle shooter, Tino Mohat, here with me today. Welcome, Tino, and thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thank you.
You're not only a rifle shooter, but you're also now working with the ISSF, and you're traveling around the world. How's that going for you?
Yeah, it's pretty interesting, yeah. The last month was pretty hard for me. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you know, it's amazing to work with such a nice guys and from the ISSF TV team and you. And I have a lot of fun, and for the moment, it's nice. Yeah.
Perfect. Now, let's talk about what happened here. What you said 7 years ago on this day.
Yeah. Yeah, today is the free position final, and now they're shooting each position, so they're shooting kneeling, standing and prone, or prone and standing in this direction, and shooting three times the five-shot series for the kneeling position, and the same for the prone position, and then two five-shot series for the standing position, then the elimination begins.
And what do you think about this shooting range here? Do you think that everyone is pretty happy with it?
Yeah, for sure. But the weather was horrible today. So they had lots of wind. So the elimination or the qualification results are not that high. Yesterday it was a perfect day, sunny, no wind. So the results yesterday from the elimination were absolutely crazy.
Wouldn't you say that the athletes here are kind of suffering from the cold? I mean, it's really unseasonably cold here.
And
we've had one day of sun. All the other days have been rainy, windy, and cold.
Yeah.
And so if anyone's shooting the qualifications outside, they're really feeling it.
Yeah, for sure. Especially in the standing position, because it's the last position, and it's quite heavy because the wind affected also the body. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty tough to get some high results.
Now, earlier you and I were talking, and you said that you had won the gold here, what was it, 7 years ago?
Yeah, wow.
On this day.
Yeah, it was on this day, but it was air rifle. Mm-hmm. And so for me at Munich, it's a nice range, and I have a great experience here.
In just a couple seconds, we can introduce our eight finalists today. You and I were talking before, Tino, about how we've got some new faces going against some really experienced shooters. Everybody's starting off with a score of zero, so it's really anybody's game, as we've seen all week long.
To the Olympic Shooting Range Munich, the finals competition for the 50-meter rifle three-position.
On firing point H, representing France, we have Cyril Graff. And how is he doing in qualifications, Cyril?
Representing France.
He was in a qualification with the 8th place and with a qualification score of 11.64. And it's nice kneeling. He did a good job in the kneeling position and really good job in prone position. But for the standing, it should be interesting. So I think we need a little bit of advantage now.
On firing point G, representing Finland, we have Juho Korki.
Quite young shooter.
He's never entered into a final round of a World Cup in this discipline before. On firing point F, representing Switzerland, we have Marcel Berger.
Probably one of the best prone and kneeling shooters in the World Cup, but I think he needs a good kneeling and a prone.
On firing point E, representing Serbia, we have Nemanja Miroslavljevic.
Yeah, everybody knows Nemanja.
Otherwise known as Slim by some people.
Yeah.
He just won the bronze in Shanghai earlier in the year. On firing point D, representing the Russian Federation, we have Artem Kajibekov.
Yeah, a real legend in the shooting world. Yeah, it's really interesting that he's here in the final. And
just have to see how it works out for him.
Yep.
On firing point C, representing Germany, we have Nicholas Schallenberger.
Yeah, quite talented shooter here in Germany. He's a professional. And
but he's never entered into a final World Cup before,
so
it's another new face that we're seeing. On firing point B, representing Italy, we have Marco Di Nicolo.
He was 8th place here in Munich in 2005.
Yeah, a real strong standing position, so I think you have a good chance to win a medal here.
And on firing point A, representing Norway, we have Ole Christian Brun.
Probably the strongest in the standing position. And great result in the qualification. 11.71 on these conditions, it's absolutely fantastic.
Now, this is completely different setup. During qualifications, they're shooting outside. Now they're shooting inside.
Yep.
And where that, before with the old finals format, when they would come in to the final with their qualifications and then just shoot and standing and there's no wind and nothing that's going to affect their shooting, there was more of a chance that the person who came in first place could put more distance between it.
Yep.
But now it's really interesting because they're all starting off with zero.
Yep.
And like I said, we're starting off in the kneeling position. They've got 200 seconds to shoot each series. And there's three series of five shots.
Yep, that's right.
So if you were to put your money down on somebody, who would you?
I think, yeah, I don't know. The Norway, so Ole Christian Brun is he's so strong since 2 years. But should be also interesting what the German is doing because he's just making training here.
Mm-hmm.
And he knows exactly the conditions here in the final hall. And I think, you know, he has this home home advantage or what you call it. I don't know. And so it should be interesting. But also, when Katja Bickhoff is in the final, you have to
be careful.
You have to be careful.
How do you feel, Tina, when you're shooting here in Munich? I mean, it's on your own home turf. Does it work in your advantage, or do you become nervous?
No. It was always nice because you spend a lot of time at your hometown, and then short before the competition, you know quite well the shooting range, and then maybe one day before the competition, you're coming here, so you're quite relaxed. Mm-hmm. You don't have this time difference like in Fort Benning or in Changwong. So I think it's an advantage, yeah. And now we see a great shooting from Berge.
Really good, coming off of two tens. And now a 9.9. 10.1 for Corky.
So we have an 8.4 for Schallenberger, so he's quite nervous, I think.
Maybe shooting on his own home turf does not work for him. 9.3 now for Schallenberger.
So Nemanja is in the lead.
He's coming off at 10.8. He's really starting off strong, which is really important. You know, it's hard to make up points if you're starting off a little bit below the others.
For him, it's quite easy, the procedure of the final, and because he's so fast in his shooting, and to change the tactics is also a really important thing now in this final format.
So let's take a look now at the standings after the first series. We have Mirosavljev in first place by 1.4 tenths of a point over Berge and Di Nicolo, who are tied up in second place. Fourth place, we have Graf. He's only 4 tenths of a point behind. I mean, there's really, really very tight. And what you'll see is once we move on from kneeling to prone, things can change around so fast. You know, it just depends on what position you are strongest in.
Start.
Okay, back on now to Schallenberger. Starting off with a 10.4.
Yeah, you know he needs some perfect shots to be in that race.
Mirosavljev coming off of a 10.5. Now with this new finals format, it seems as if it's more of a fair final for everybody because you have to shoot in every single position.
Yeah.
You know, if you're a strong standing position in the old finals format, you know, you got an ace, basically.
Yeah, that's true. But you know, there's a big fight between the athletes now, and because they delayed the qualification result, so it's much more fair in the final. But to delay the qualification, you have you are in front with 10 points or 5 points. Yeah, it's a big discussion in the athletes. So between the athletes, so I really like this format because it's fair and it's really interesting what happens, and also during the positions it's interesting what they're doing, how fast they can preparate.
Mm-hmm. Okay, back on now to Kadjibekov and Di Nicolo.
Oh, Kadjibekov, if they plays at the moment.
Di Nicolo coming off a 10.2 with a 10.9. That's the way you kind of climb up the scoreboard, if you can shoot like that. And Korki.
Nemanja's that strong, amazing.
Yeah, 52.6.
It's a kneeling position, it's wow.
I think that he is determined to get on the highest step of the podium today.
For me, the kneeling position was... not that bad, not a great experience in kneeling position for me. It's always shooting with poles, and it's you need a lot of training to be good at kneeling position.
So let's take a look again now at the standings. Miroslav Sabaliev holding on to first place by 1.2 tenths of a point over Di Nicolo. We have Bergay in third place, 6 tenths of a point behind, and Brin 2.2 tenths of a point, and in fourth place. We've got one more series in the kneeling position, and then there's going to be a 7-minute changeover time. And what can we expect during that changeover time?
Yeah, I don't know. There are different kind of tactics then. So somebody is taking more care of to adjust the rifle, and some of them are really, really fast in doing the changings and to adjust the rifle. So it should be interesting what happened, for sure. Because it's including the sighting shots, and some is more focused on to have more sighting shots, and some more focused on the adjustment of the rifle.
Okay, back on now to Korki. He's currently in eighth place and starting off with a 10.5. Kadjibekov starting off with a 10.6. Followed by a 9.9. Graf shooting in the tens.
Yeah. And the Mania is really strong at the moment.
Graf the 9.1. On now to Brin.
Oh, it's amazing stability from Brin.
He does not sway at all.
Yeah.
He's just ramrod straight. 9.9 for Miroslaviev. He's a great guy. He's a really, really funny, very kind person. Oh, 10.7. Nice way to finish up this third. Now, after this series, nobody can start making adjustments until the last person has shot. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
One more shot for Di Nicolo.
Now we have Burger on the second place. For him, it's really important to be in front after the prone position. He's the best prone shooter, I think, from the eight finalists. And but he needs this little advantage for the standing position.
Okay, so let's take a look now. We have Miroslaviev. His great lead is dwindling down. He's 2 tenths of a point now in the lead over Bergay. Di Nicolo is in third place. He's holding on to that. By a considerable amount. I mean, behind him, we have Brin, who's 4 points behind. Things can definitely change around. We're moving on now to the prone position. And during this changeover time, tell me again, what are they doing with their rifle?
Yeah, I think they changed the hook, definitely. And for the prone position, you see the hand stop. Mm-hmm. They're changing, and maybe the butt plate. And but everybody have this individual changes. So some of them are using the same hook or the same butt plate. Some of them are changing the whole, you know, really every part of the stock. And it's really important to be fast now. But yeah, even more for the standing position. For the prone position, they can easily shot in 3 or 2 minutes, 5-6 shots.
Mm-hmm.
So it's even more interesting what happens between prone and standing, because there's a big change. So they have to build up the stand and adjust their rifles with a hand block, and the hook is completely different than in prone position.
So we're going to check back in after these men set up for the prone position. And we're back here in the finals hall with Tina Mohawk from Germany. The gentlemen have just are finishing up their 7 minutes of changeover time, which they had to change over from the kneeling position to the prone position, and then started in on their fighting shots. And I saw that the first person to shoot they had 200 seconds left over. So these guys move fast.
Yeah, for sure. Everybody was really fast. It's amazing, yeah?
You know, during the women's event the other day, we were watching, and it looked like they were really nervous. They were dropping, you know, equipment and dropping this and that, trying to. Stop. I mean, your heart must be racing out of your chest.
Yeah.
You know, and then to calm that down, and it just seems like it's a lot of stress for the shooters.
Yeah, it's another competition in the competition to handle all this adjustment and to be cool and okay. Now I have to do that. Now I have to do that. So it's also we have to train it before.
And again, in the prone position, we're going to have 3 series of 5 shots, and they have 150 seconds to shoot each series. Does that seem like it's enough?
Well, I think so, mm-hmm. Especially for Nemanja.
Yeah, exactly. I was talking to him before, because when we were in Shangwang, it seemed like he was taking longer to shoot, and he said that he had to adjust his shooting now to this finals format. Nice start with a 10.4. Now, who would you say is the strongest shooter in the prone position?
Definitely Berger.
Mm-hmm.
And his first shot was 10.8, right? but really, he needs some advantage before the standing position. I think in the standing position, you have small problems. Or the others are quite good at this position, so he definitely needs a good prone position.
Berger starting up with a 10.8 and a 10.5. He does take his time between shots, that is for sure.
Yeah.
Coming off a 10.5 with a 10.2.
And he's not that satisfied, because he knows, okay, standing position is coming.
So it must be a little bit unnerving for him. That
probably
got that in the back of his mind, that
the
pressure is definitely on to finish off well. Corky finishing off with a 10.8. And now on to Kajibekov.
Now he's a little bit in danger because of the 8th place. So at the moment, he's not that strong in the standing position. It's always crazy to see him, because the positions are completely different from the other athletes.
And you said that he was probably one of the strongest shooters in our final today. So
maybe I'm wrong.
Well, you never know. Sometimes you have a good day, sometimes you don't.
Yeah.
Did Niccolo coming off a 10.0? And finishing off with a 10.4. So after the first prone series, we have Miroslavlev in first place by 0.3 lead over Berger, who is really putting the pressure on. DiNicolo in third place. He's 2.2 behind Berger. And Brin is holding on to fourth. He's 3.2 behind. So you can really see here there are some pretty good differences between the placements here.
Yes.
Again, we're going to have two more series, and then we're going to go into the standing. After the standing series, the two standing series, 7th and 8th place will be eliminated.
For the next competition series, load.
Yeah, for the moment, we have the best kneeling and prone shooters in the front, and it should be really interesting what happens in the standing position.
Now, would you say that Mira Sabaliev is strong in the standing position, or not as much?
Sometimes. So for the shot series, five shot series, he is really strong because he definitely liked this fast shooting and But for the single shot, we have to wait because then it's completely different rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
So you have this single shot mode, and you have between the shots you have a long time. Then there's the commentating the results. So it's you're always thinking about that. So it's absolutely different than the shot series.
And they know exactly where they're standing after each shot.
Yeah.
10.6 for Brin, and another 10.6. He's having a great series here. Again, on to Berge. That 9.8 seems a little bit surprising for him.
Yeah.
Again, a 9.8.
Now it's also a question of material. Mm-hmm. So this is really important. Because of the decimal scoring, you definitely need a good material. You have to test it three or twice or maybe four times a year.
Mm-hmm.
And you need ammunition for wind, for cold weather, for warm weather. It's
a lot to think about.
It's a tough game, yeah.
Schellenberger coming up at 10.2 with a 10.3.
I think all eight shooters are professionals in the shooting world. So
Di Nicolo coming off a 10.5. With a 9.8. And let's take a look now at the standings. Mira Sabaliev has finished off with a perfect 10.9, which has put some difference between he and Berge now. Mira Sabaliev is holding on to first place by 1.5 points. Berge is in second. Di Nicolo, 1.5 points behind Berge. And Brin is in fourth place, almost 2 points behind Di Nicolo. Schellenberger and Kirky are holding on to 7th and 8th place. And it looks like it could be really anyone's game. I mean, we still have to get through the prone and get into the standing.
And now we have the youngest shooter on place 7 and 8.
Yeah.
But I know Nicolas Schellenberger is a quite good standing shooter.
Okay. So things could change around again.
Yeah, for sure. And also Cookie is good in a standing position.
This is the last series in the prone position. After that, we'll be going into a 9-minute changeover. And that we'll bring the men up into the standing position. Schellenberger starting off with a 10.2.
So Kachepikov is coming back in the ranking. But it's good to see him on this competition and also on the World Cups because for everybody he's a legend,
mm-hmm.
Olympic champion, and the way he's shooting is fascinating.
Again, on to Mira Sabaliev. Started off with a 9.9, the 10.1. He does have, he did have 1.5 points advantage, but I'm sure he doesn't want to give that up when that's obvious with that 10.7.
It's interesting to see after 9.9 or 10.0, he's always shooting at 10.8 or 10.7.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the way you have to push yourself in this kind of finals. When you have a bad shot, then come on, you can do it. And before 10.7, I'm back in the game. So
it's true. Just one bad shot can bring you all the way down, screaming down the scoreboard into 8th place.
Yeah.
And the talent that we've got in today's final, it's pretty unreal, I have to say. Bergé coming off of 2 10-point sixes. The 10.5. Last shot for Brin.
Also Kachepikov shooting a perfect series.
And Brin finishing off the 10.3. Korki still is holding on to eighth place. But as you said, he's a really strong standing position shooter, so things could change around again. Schallenberger finishing off with a 10.7. And let's take a look now at the rankings. We've got Miroslavljev in first place by 1.1 tenth of a point. He lost a little bit of his lead, but not too much. Bergé still in second place. And 2.5 points behind him, we have Di Nicolo. Brin is in fourth place, and he's only 6 tenths of a point behind. So we're going to be going into the standing position. Tino, can you tell us now exactly what the guys are going to be doing?
Nowadays, yeah, they have to build up first of all the stand for the standing position, and then they change the hook, the butt places. Then they need a hand block, and it's a tough game to be fast and to make many sighting shots as possible, and because you need for sure a few sighting shots. And at the moment, these two are in our elimination. So everybody's now in rush a little bit.
And this is the position where we've seen in the past the standings have changed dramatically. They have already been in the kneeling and the prone, and now they've got to be up on their feet. So we will tune in just a little bit when these guys are finished and check in with them.
Is leading by 1.1 now with 311.1. Marcel Berger maintaining his.
We're back here in the finals hall with Tino Mohat. Thank you again, Tino, for joining me today. The men have just changed over from the prone position, and they're now in the standing position. They're doing their sighting shots right now. What do you think about the sighting shots? They seem like a little bit surprising to you, or?
Yeah, maybe. So everybody's doing a lot of sighting shots. Instead of Schallenberger, it's just 3 shots, but the rest was really fast and adjust the rifle. So when we did the test last year, it was for everybody, it was really pretty tough to make some sighting shots. But now everybody did a lot of training, that kind of adjustment. And now it's quite easy for everybody to put nearly 5 shots.
And we saw a couple of shaky hands when they were changing over some of the things on their rifle. I'm sure that their arms must be really tired after being in prone position, and so.
Yeah, it's a long day for sure. Yeah. It's a 3x40 qualification, and then after that you shot a 3x20, nearly, and so it's quite tough, yeah.
And we have 2 series now of 5 shots, and they have 250 seconds to shoot each series. After the second series, 7th and 8th place will be eliminated, and then we'll be going on to single shots.
So now the pressure is a little bit on Schallenberger and Kuki. And it should be interesting what happened with Berger. But maybe I'm wrong, maybe he did a lot of training in standing position, but also for the qualification he was the weakest athlete for the standing position, so it should be interesting what happened now.
Let's focus in on Miroslavljev, who is currently holding on to first place. And would you say he's pretty strong in the standing position?
Yeah, I think especially for the 5 shot series. Because he can handle it quite easy. He's so fast, and he's not using the move. Okay.
Okay, an 8.8 from Miroslavljev.
Have you seen his reaction?
It was immediate. On the other hand, we have Schallenberger, who started off with a 10.8. Di Nicolo coming off of a 9.0.
Should be nice when we have if you have Schallenberger also in the medal as well. raising up a little bit because of the spectators. We have a complete full final hall now.
Exactly. And it's been like this all week long. The finals hall has just been packed full of people. So 8.4 there for Di Nicolo. It's kind of a surprise as well. Grin coming off of an 8.9.
10.9 for Miroslav.
Yeah, like you were saying earlier, you know, he shoots shoots a little bit low, then all of a sudden comes back and nails it. On now to Corky, who's currently in eighth place. And he's coming off of an 8.9. With a 9.3.
So everybody's not shooting really high results at the moment.
No, not on this series. It doesn't look like it. Another 8.6 for Mirosavljev.
Because everybody knows now, okay, now I have to be in the first six positions and places.
And they know exactly where they're standing, and that just adds a little bit more pressure to it. Schallenberger coming off of a 9.6. We have about 100 more seconds before this series is finished.
Oh, we have Berger in the lead at the moment.
So things are changing around. Schallenberger taking his time for this last shot.
With a 7.7.
Oof. And finishing off with a 9.6. Berger coming off a 10.1. He's shot in the 8 ring, right in the center of this series, but still holding on to first place.
Is waiting about Berger.
Finishing off with a 9.0.
But I think he's satisfied with this performance.
So we have Mirosavljev, who has come back up. He's in first place only by 0.4 of a point over Berger. Di Nicolo is in third place, 4.2 of a point behind Berger. We're going to have to take a close look now at Schallenberger and Corky. They are currently holding on to 7th and 8th place. And after the series, if they are still holding on to those places, they will be eliminated. Although it's a really, really tight fight for 7th and 8th now between Corky, Schallenberger, Graf, and Khachabekov.
Next competition series, Loaf. Start.
Let's focus in on Schallenberger. He's one of the youngest ones here in our final today. Yeah, you gotta take your hat off to him. He made it into the final, the first one. starting off with 10.9. Apparently, he would like to stay in the game. Corky at 10.2. Oh, 8.1, but it's not going to help him out.
And now he's really in danger. He needs 3 perfect shots.
Khachabekov is now holding on to 7th place. As you were saying, he is a legend in this discipline, and we'll just see if he can get back into it, have a couple good shots, and stay in the game. Ooh.
Oh.
And he is not at all happy with this 8.3.
Scheinberger have a great performance until now. No, he climbed up from the 7th place to the 3rd place.
Unbelievable. Yeah. And Graf coming off of a 10.4 with a 9.1. Oh, an 8.0 for Schellenberger.
But now it's nice because we have a reaction of the spectators and everybody's making some sounds. And this is the atmosphere we want to create.
Exactly. It's very exciting for the spectators. I think it's really stressful for the shooters. Bergé coming off of a 9.8.
Shot for Berger.
Stop.
Okay, we have to say goodbye to Kurki and Kachubekov.
In fact, it's too bad for 7th place. We definitely have to say goodbye to Finland's Juho Kurki. He put up a good fight, it just was not quite enough. And from the Russian Federation, we're going to have to say goodbye to Artem Kachubekov from the Russian Federation. From here now, we will be going into single shots, and after each single shot, the lowest person on the scoreboard will be eliminated. Bergé has now overtaken Miroslaviev by half a point. De Nicolo is holding him on to third place by 2.8-tenths of a point. But right on his heels, we have Brin.
Moved him up 3 or 4 places on the leaderboard.
So it's Schellenberger now who is in the hot seat, although he's only 4-tenths of a point behind Graf. And if he can nail another one of those 10.9s, that will help him right out.
For the moment, it's really a big surprise that we have Berge in the lead. And it should be really interesting what happens now. Because now it's a complete different shooting. Now you have this single shot modus with long preparation time and
only 50 seconds. In the old finals format, they had 75 seconds for each shot. Do you think 50 seconds seems like it's enough?
Yeah.
Obviously,
yeah,
for Miroslaviev, it totally
for
is.
Him, for sure.
De Nicolo at 8.9.
Okay, Schellenberger 10.0.
9.9 for Bergé.
And so we have our next
unfortunately,
it's not enough.
We're going to have to say goodbye to Nicholas Schellenberger from Germany. His first time into a World Cup. I definitely take my hat off to him. Really great shooting. Unfortunately, it just was not enough to stay in. We have Bergé still in first place over Miroslaviev. He's gained 1/10 of a point. And in third place, we have Brin. De Nicolo is 2/10 of a point behind. It's going to really be right now the fight for fifth place between Graf, De Nicolo, and Brin. Graf finishing off with a 10.4, a 9.2 for De Nicolo, and just waiting on Bergé. Ooh, a 7.9 for Bergé. And that is definitely going to change things around here.
Not enough for De Nicolo, yeah.
No, unfortunately, with that 9.2 for De Nicolo, he is going to be going home in fifth place, representing Italy. We have now Miroslaviev almost a point ahead of Bergé. That 7.9 just knocked him down a bit. And almost 2 points behind, we have Bryn. We've got Graf and Bryn only 0.3 of a point behind. So it's really anybody's game right now for fourth place. And this is a huge one, because after this shot, then we're going for the medals.
Start.
For Nemanja.
9.9 for Graf, 9.8 for Bryn.
So we have to say goodbye to Graf.
Absolutely. 0.3 of a point behind. He's not going to make it to the podium. Yeah. And Bergé with a 9.7.
So the next
gentleman that's going to have to leave today is Cyril Graf from France, finishing off in fourth place. We're going to be moving on now to the medals. We have 1.8 of a point separating Bryn from Bergé, and also 1.8 of a point between Bergé and Miroslaviev. What do you think we're going to see in these next shots? Would you put your money down on anybody or not?
Okay, for me it should be nice when we have Nemanja on the first place.
Yeah.
I really like him. And but you never know, you never know. You see that before with the 7.9 from Berger, so we have to wait what happens.
Start.
Now 10.2 for Bryn.
It's also interesting because Nemanja's that fast and Berger is really slow, so we have a big time
gap. Yeah. Whoa. 6.9 for Bergé knocks him down into third place, and he is going to be winning the bronze medal. Marcel Bergé winning the bronze medal. That's 6.9. Took any chance for him to be fighting out for the gold. But he still will be on the podium today, winning the bronze. I'm sure that he must be kicking himself right now.
Yeah.
So we have Miroslaviev and Bryn that are left in here. But Miroslaviev has 3.5 point lead. I have to say he's probably packed it in.
Yeah.
I don't want to jinx him by any means, but...
And I think he can handle the pressure because he's well experienced and since a few years he's at the top of the world. So
yeah, and this gold will be just the right thing for him.
Oh,
7.9? No.
Wow. And 10.8.
No, 10.8, but still, it's not enough.
It's not enough, but
no, but that's a really huge difference between the two of them. We have Bryn finishing off with a 10.8. Ole Christian Bryn. And let's take a look at our gold medalist, Nemanja Miroslaviev, winning the gold medal. The crowd absolutely loves it. They love him. He's so great. And I'm really happy to see that he's going to be on the highest step of the podium today. And let's take a look and see if we can find our silver medalist today. There he is, Ole Christian Bryn, winning the silver medal. Great shooting also for him.
Yeah.
Tino, I want to thank you.
The best qualification, Bryn, so it's good to have him on the podium. Yeah.
Exactly. I want to thank you very much for joining me today. I love working with you, and I wish you all the best of luck with your shooting in the future.
Yeah, thank you.
To thank everybody for their involvement in the World Cup here in Munich. So we would like to invite you all to the medal ceremony for this final. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen,
The medal ceremony for the 50-meter rifle three-position men's event will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mr. Gerhard Fournier, Vice President for Sport, German Shooting Federation, and Competition Manager for the World Cup here in Munich 2013. Your bronze medalist, representing Switzerland, Marcel Berger. Your silver medalist, representing Norway, Ole Christian Brien. And your gold medalist, representing Serbia, Nemanja Milosavljević. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Serbia. So one more time, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to the winners of the 50-meter rifle.